Hello guys, I'm Krim. I hope you're all doing well, and this is another episode of Krim's Randomness. If you play a lot of drums, you can imagine there are a lot of broken and used drumsticks, and usually I would throw them into the crowd right after a concert, but sadly playing a concert or playing any tours became quite of a rare thing to do these days, so that's why a lot of the drumsticks are piling up here in my room, and I wanted to give them somehow like a second life, and so I had the idea to manufacture this tiny mini drumstick, kind of a keychain from my used drumsticks. And this is the topic for today's Krimh's Randomness episode. So I have two boxes here. This is category A, so these are the best for the little souvenir. What is important is that the tip is still in good condition, so can be that, you know, the stick is kind of messed up, but the tip is still good. I do have quite a lot of these. And over here we have category B. They're not good enough anymore, but I would still consider it being, you know, one piece of a drumstick, and they will wait for shows to happen, and then I will throw them into the crowd. And category number C, or number three, however you wanna say it, this is not anymore a drumstick. This is just too dangerous to throw into the crowd. I will probably poke someone's eye with it, and I don't want that. So these just simply become firewood. So this little guy right here, that's my prototype I made a couple of months ago, just to experiment, to know how long it should be, where to attach the ring, where to put the logo, and just to get an overall feeling of how it should look like. So this is gonna be the template for all the other ones. And I do have some basic tools such as a saw, a drill, lots of sandpaper, clear coats. And so I will use this. I do not have any professional gear, but I think it should be fine. Will be a lot of work. And once I've figured out a method, I will continue making more and more. This is my workstation. It is very basic, very DIY style, but I think it should be fine. I got here some pieces of wood to protect the table from the drilling. Got all the drumsticks I want to work on. I even have some extra tools over there just in case if I need to. And I did some work already off the camera. And that is basically, I marked all the drumsticks where I want to cut them afterwards. So they're gonna be roughly 10 centimeters long. And if you take a closer look, I also painted a small dot over there. So this dot is gonna be the hole where I will attach the ring afterwards. And I figured it's the smartest if I keep the drumstick in its original length as long as possible, because it's easier to control, and then working with the sandpaper, it's just easier to rotate. So yeah, first thing is gonna be drilling the hole with the wood drill. Then I'm gonna take a countersink bit and I will enlarge the hole a little bit more and also take off some of the splinters. Then I have to sand it because, as you see, it is very rough surface and I don't want to destroy anyone's pockets in case you use it on your keys. So there's a lot of sanding involved, and almost at the end, I will cut it with a saw. So this is what I will do right now. Let's get the drill and let's get started with drilling the holes. Step number two is to take my countersink bit right here, and then I will work on the hole again. So this side, for example, looks nice, but on the other side we do have some splinters sticking out and I want to remove them. Plus, it looks much nicer if the hole sits a little bit deeper and the edges of the hole are going to look a bit smoother. So this is what I will do now. All right, the next step is going to be probably the most time-consuming one, which means I need to sand the tip. Because if you look closely, some of them do look a bit more rough. And others, for example, they broke right at the beginning, right at the rimshot area. And so the tip is a bit more, you know, smoother. So what I will have to do is now, by using sandpaper and this guy right here, I just basically take off all the rough surface so that it is as smooth as possible. And then I will use some sandpaper. And now you get why I want to keep the stick, if it's not broken in the middle, in its length, because it's much easier to rotate the stick like this. So this gonna take quite a lot of time, all of the sticks right here. But once I have done this process and it feels very smooth, then it's the time to cut it into the right length. So wish me luck and let's get started. To cut the sticks, I built myself a slider for the saw. It's a very basic setup, but I think it really works very well. So in here, we're gonna put the drumstick like this. So it is very tight fit, as you can see. So the stick is not moving. And then we use the upper wood as a slider for the saw, more or less. I measured the distance from the center of the blade so that whenever I put the stick right there, I can just go forward with the saw and I know that I will have a clean cut. So it looks something like this. And there we go. It is pretty straight cut. And this is what I will do for all the other drumsticks. Hello there, guess what? I'm sanding again. Yep, there is still a lot more sanding that has to be done. And I have been already busy and I'm already a couple hours in sanding. So what has happened so far? Well, I cut all the drumsticks. They got the hole, they're pretty smooth. But the end of the drumstick where I cut it, it is very sharp and doesn't look good. So I need to work on this right now. So I kind of want to imitate an actual butt end of the drumstick. So yeah, we have to make the booty round again. And therefore I use the obvious tools. I use a file first off, just take off the edge, start to get a nice curve on it. Then I'm using an 80 grit sandpaper to smoothen it down even more. And for the fine tuning, 120 grit. And once this is done and it feels nice, I put on the ring already, and this mini drumstick is ready for the first layer of clear coat. So I have done around 10-12-ish of the mini drumsticks. They're ready. They're around 40 still to go. And yeah, it just takes extremely long because I have to use basically hand tools. I do not have any professional tools or a professional workshop, which would of course speed up everything, but yeah, it has to be all done by hand. But I will just use the time to listen to some audiobooks and, you know, just get going. Enough talking, that's what I will do right now, and see you in a bit.
Now it's time to throw on the first layer of clear coat, just to kind of seal the wood a little bit before I put the logo on. So that you know that this is really a Krimh drumstick, I have to personalize it somehow. And the original plan of putting the logo right here actually didn't work that well, so I just thought, why not sign it? So this is what I will do as the next step. In case you wonder, this thing here is just to hang them after they're being sprayed with clear coat. So let me sign all of them. I think they look pretty sweet. Let me know what you think about it in the comments, and I will go back to work.
Alright guys, this is the end of the video, I hope you enjoyed it, and if you want to get a small Krimh drumstick, then just follow the link in the description. Keep in mind, they won't be always in stock, depending on how many broken drumsticks I have, and of course how many I've made, but I try to update them of course. And so, thank you very much for watching, stay safe, and see you in the next video. Bye bye!